You know, it's really unfair to paint this whole idea that the government or Turkey as a whole is some corrupt, awful place. Hey guys, welcome back to another episode of Turkey Unmasked. Today we're going to take a little bit more of a serious turn, and we're going to discuss Turkey's image in the West. You know, election year is upon us here in Turkey. Of course, you know, both political parties, or the table of six versus the other table of two. Things are picking up. There's going to be some, there's going to be a windfall of kind of talk and rhetoric back and forth. But what does this mean for the folks in the U.S. watching, or in Europe watching, that, you know, has this preconceived notion of what Turkey is? I've read some articles lately in like Financial Times and New York Times, and I've seen a lot of kind of this perception of Turkey, and especially as the government, as being like this evil power that is trying to, you know, thwart all of these forces, these friendly forces, and just be this, you know, this negative kind of connotation. And I think that that's really unfair. Being a Westerner here, this country is not a country as diverse as a lot of countries in Europe, or as diverse as a lot of country, or excuse me, North America. But this country isn't a country that doesn't welcome other people. We talk about the government. We say that the Turkish government is cruel, or they're this. The Turkish government's taken in 4.5 million refugees over the last 8-9 years, more than any other country. When you look at the humanitarian impact that they make in Syria and Africa and other places, in Libya, that they volunteer, that folks raise money for during the holidays, they send food and animals for whole animal butchery in Africa. You know, it's really unfair to paint this whole idea that the government or Turkey as a whole is some corrupt, awful place. You know, it's just something that's really, I've been reading so much of it lately, and I guess it's mainly left-focused, you know, media trying to paint the current regime as, you know, some negative influence. You know, like the current one, don't like the current one. Like the, you know, like the opposition party, don't like the opposition party. For me, it's unfair to characterize Turkey as a whole based on your ideas of a few folks. So this message today was more or less to talk about the things that we don't see, the things that we don't pay attention to in the West, because it's not something that's highly advertised. We talk about the Turkish Coast Guard and their rescuing of African immigrants almost, daily, where they're trying to cross the Aegean into Greece or to Italy, and they're getting pushed back. The Coast Guards from these European governments are pushing them back, yet the Turkish Coast Guard's picking them up and bringing them back to shore, and those folks are given asylum until they can figure out their cases here in Turkey. You know, this is something that I think that we don't address, that we don't look at, something that really bothers me as a whole when you talk about Turkish military, Turkish government, Turkish people. Okay, because there are people on the ground here doing tremendous things to try and better humanity, try to help those that have nothing. And it's important that the West takes an open approach to how they view Turkey. Okay, I could sit here and I can paint one perception this way, and I can paint another perception that way, and it would be the most incorrect thing that I could do. Why? Is there good? Absolutely. Is there bad? Sure there is. But look anywhere in the world and you'll find the exact same thing. Look at Turkey as a whole, at their whole body of work, what they've done. We talk about the Ukraine-Russia conflict, and the fact that Turkey has negotiated this grain corridor, which has ensured that basically we don't have a food shortage through most of Europe, and especially into the Middle East and Africa. That's not something that we shouldn't appreciate and understand. It's something that we have to look at and say, okay, Turkey has a significance. Yes, they do have some Russian cooperation. And yes, they are supporting Ukraine in certain terms as well. There is this sense of neutrality where they're going to be more Ukraine focused, you know, supporting, but they're also not turning and trying to neglect Russia and understanding that at some point in the future, this conflict will end. And I think that we all around the world, especially as 2023 were predicted recessions, I think more governments could do more to try to understand what we can do, that by trying to defeat this foe, we're debilitating ourselves. And sometimes, you know, I'm not a diplomat, but for me, someone that's lived around the world, understanding that diplomacy has many faces and has many different ways of negotiation, it just seems to me that maybe the rest of the world could take a look at how Turkey's navigated this scene and say, you know what? They've done a pretty damn good job. They've been fighting inflation. They've been fighting some of the things that's going on. But the last 2 months, inflation in Turkey is going down because of lower fuel costs. If Turkey has to look and turn to Russia for certain instances to lower the burden on their population, then tell me exactly, what should they do? Should we criticize them and say, you're doing wrong? No, we should say, you know what? We understand you're taking care of your people. Just like in America, we expect that the government's going to do the right thing by the American people, that the European governments are going to do the right thing by the European people. So when we do this, when we look at Turkey and we say, hey, they're doing that, they're doing this, stop the shit. Look at it and understand the whole picture. Because Turkey has an obligation to Turkey. All right? And the people that live within the borders of Turkey. It's not always going to match up ideally, philosophically, with the U.S. and the West. It's not going to match up philosophically with China and Japan or the Middle East on every occasion. Each country has to protect their own people, their own borders, and understand that each way is going to have different obstacles compared to the next. All right. If we look at American diplomacy, that's nothing that we should rah-rah about. There's been several failures in the last 3-4 years. We talk about the other issues that we've had. You know, I mean, I think that more of the world should do more to try to understand. I think the world could do more to try to be more understanding, right? I think the greatest intelligence that we have in this life is the ability to look at information from multiple sources across all facets, from left to right to middle and everything in between, and be able to make a decision based on the information at hand. Not just because John said this, or Muhammad said this, or this guy said this. It should be based on the body of information that you yourself have researched. And if you research Turkey, and you really take a full whole perspective of what they've done, you'll see that there's more greater good than there is going to be bad. But again, it's just something, it's something that's been kind of bothering me. It's obvious, but it's something that I think that we really need to address, you know, and it should start with doing a better job of trying to understand people. And if you're interested in Turkey, or you want to criticize Turkey, or you hate Turkey, all three categories should be looking at information from multiple sources and making the best decision about what Turkey is, who Turkey is, and where Turkey will be moving forward. For me, over the next 4 or 5 months until we get through with the election, it makes no difference. Turkey will be what Turkey is. Turkey will not change philosophically overnight. Turkey will not change diplomatically overnight. Things will continue to be what they are. The people are who they are. Our land, this area, is what it is. And so if we understand that, we can have a better perspective and we can stop, you know, painting pictures and putting ideas out there that people don't know. Come to Turkey, see Turkey, drop your comments below. Tell me your experiences in Turkey, good, bad, negative, positive, because you're going to have all of them. But again, I just needed to say, please, for the love of whatever God you have, do your own research and paint a picture that is accurate and that is real with the information that you came up with. Thanks, guys.